Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to present the Grand Marshal and the Student Government President, led by the members of the FIU Marching Band Drumline. Led by members of the FIU Marching Band Color Guard, it is our honor to present the Distinguished Platform Party, the faculty and staff of FIU, and the president of FIU, Dr. Mark B. Rosenberg. Thank you.
Good evening. You have any idea how long I was waiting for that to be in person again? Let's dial this up to an 11, shall we? Good evening, everybody! I'm Jörg Reinhold, Chairperson of the Faculty Senate, member of the FIU Board of Trustees, and Grand Marshal of this ceremony. FIU's 2021 Penta Convocation Ceremony is now declared open! Please rise for the singing of the National Anthem and the FIU Alma Mater. Will Angelica Ramon please come forward to lead us? Angelica is a freshman majoring in music education. You will find the words to our National Anthem and FIU Alma Mater on the screens above. I encourage you to sing along.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we'd watch were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets were clear, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave? To thee, dear FIU, with voices loud and true, Alma Mater, falter never, shine forever gold and blue. We fly our banners high, every culture we
seated. Thank you, Angelica, for that wonderful performance. A special thanks also to Barry Bernhardt and the FIU Marching Band. Several members of the band are also freshmen. How about that? Please join me in a round of applause. On behalf of the faculty, it is my pleasure to officially welcome you to FIU and to officially welcome also our sophomores. We are honored to have the opportunity to impart knowledge and guide you in the discovery of new knowledge. We will set high standards and demand excellence and expect to see you here in 4 years 4 years, okay? To celebrate your graduation. We know you can meet and exceed those standards and reach your potential as engaged global citizens. We look forward to the incredible journey ahead of us. And now it is my pleasure to call to the podium our Provost and Executive Vice President, Dr. Kenneth G. Furton.
Good evening. On behalf of the entire FIU community, I'm delighted to welcome you to the 2021 Panther Convocation Ceremony. Panther Convocation is the beginning of your FIU experience. And for our sophomores, we wanted to give you this experience that we could not give you last year due to the pandemic. Now, universities are built on traditions that bring us together to experience pride and to celebrate as a community. Your introduction to the university life and traditions starts here at Panther Convocation. Because as the newest members of our FIU family, you play an important role in learning and continuing our traditions. We expect to see you back here in 3 or 4 years, you sophomores, 3 years. And our advisors understand that you must earn 30 credits throughout the year. We will be here to make sure the courses are available and to assist you in any way possible. This might be your first day at FIU, but you already have many, many people who are rooting for your success and who are supporting you. Of course, you have your family, your friends, your loved ones, of course, but you also have the people who are here on the stage behind me, here to celebrate with you. Amongst me are the other university leadership, all of whom felt it was critically important to be here today to welcome you and to let you know that at our FIU, every student counts, and each and every one of you students out there, you count. And so now it's my privilege to introduce the Distinguished Platform Party. I'll ask each person to stand as your name is called and remain standing. And I also want to ask all of you to hold your applause until everyone has been introduced. In the first row, from your left to right, Gina Duarte Romero, President, Alumni Association Board of Directors. Elizabeth Behar, Senior Vice President, Academic and Student Affairs. Mark B. Rosenberg, President. Kevin B. Coughlin, Vice President, Enrollment Management and Services. Jörg Reinhold, your Grand Marshal, Professor of Physics, Chairperson of the Faculty Senate, and member of the FIU Board of Trustees. And Alexander Ribido, President, Student Government Association, and member of the FIU Board of Trustees. And in the second row, from your left to right, Michael Chang, Dean, Chaplain School of Hospitality and Tourism Management. Juan Carlos Espinosa, Dean, Honors College. Michael Heitaus, Executive Dean, College of Arts, Sciences, and Education. Anne M. Prestimo, Dean, Libraries. Brian Schreiner, Dean, College of Communication, Architecture, and the Arts. Aura L. Strickland, Dean, Nicole Wertheim, College of Nursing and Health Sciences. John Velakis, Dean, College of Engineering and Computing. Shlomi Dinar, Associate Dean, Stephen J. Green School of International and Public Affairs. Mark McGowan, Associate Dean, Robert Stempel College of Public Health and Social Work. And Arijit Sengupta, Associate Dean, College of Business. The first FIU faculty member to ascend to the university's presidency, Mark B. Rosenberg, has over 4 decades of experience in higher education leadership. Dr. Rosenberg was one of the principal architects of FIU's growth and expansion over the last 20 years, and he played a lead role in the development of both our College of Law and our College of Medicine. His efforts as president have pivoted around student success, faculty research and innovation, and fundraising. FIU has been named as the best college to work for in the United States 5 consecutive times with honor roll designation during his presidency. He was the first chancellor formally selected by the Board of Governors of the State University System of Florida, and he helped to structure the current 2-board system of university governance. He was a presidential appointee to the Task Force on Apprenticeship Expansion, and he served on the Board of Directors of the Association of Public and Land-Grant Universities, where he's chaired the Coalition of Urban Serving Universities and the Commission on Access, Diversity, and Excellence. He's also been appointed to 3 National Academy of Sciences panels, just in the past 6 years. Most recently, he co-chaired a national roundtable on the future of STEM education. Locally, he's the first academic ever to serve as the chair of the Greater Miami Chamber of Commerce, and he's a member of the City National Bank Board of Directors. He's the author, editor, and co-editor of 7 books and numerous scholarly articles on Latin America. Dr. Rosenberg holds a PhD from the University of Pittsburgh, a BA from Miami University of Ohio, where he was Phi Beta Kappa. He was a Fulbright Research Scholar, and he's a member on the Council on Foreign Relations in New York. He and his wife are the proud parents of 2 FIU graduates. I'm honored to introduce to you the 5th president of FIU, Dr. Mark B. Rosenberg.
Provost, thank you. Good evening. New students, returning students, friends, family members, this is a very special occasion that which we are gathered here this evening. Indeed, we are welcoming you to our FIU family, in some cases, for the first time in person. We understand what a challenge the last few years have been, but here we are together, and we will go forward together, class of 2024 and class of 2025. And let me say that you should feel good that you are now on this journey. You should feel good to be on your way to a high-quality education. You should feel good that you are now here with us for our Panther convocation. And let me tell you, we have never have we doubted that you would be here. We look at you, classes, and we see that among you are future teachers, engineers, scientists, poets, soldiers, entrepreneurs, architects, lawyers, band leaders, journalists, technology experts, hospitality professionals, diplomats, leaders, maybe a mayor, maybe a senator, maybe a legislator, a city or a county commissioner, nurses, doctors, psychologists, coaches, health practitioners, clergy, police, intelligence analysts, public administrators, a university professor, a university president. Heck, I'm confident that out here could be a president of the United States in the future, right here among you. So we look at you, classes, and we see students, we see learners who belong nowhere else but right here at our FIU. And this evening, as we welcome you to our university, we want to make a few promises. Can we make a few promises to you? We promise you a 21st century education and adventures in learning. We promise you support that you deserve, advisors, tutors, peer mentors, to ensure that you graduate in 3 or 4 years. We promise you a motivated and challenging faculty who believe deeply that each and every one of you can succeed. And we promise you an amazing community of fellow students like you who are passionate about life, about learning, about family, about friends, about community. And we promise you a university that fosters excellence each and every day, that is committed to getting better at being better, because we understand that your success is our success. The better you get, the better we'll get. And in return, we do expect just a few things from you Panthers. We expect you to graduate on time. 3 years, 4 years, taking 30 credit hours a year. We expect you to use the resources that are here in abundance, advisors, tutors. Let us help you stay on track with your academic and career goals. And we expect you to work hard in your studies. Get an internship. We expect you to get involved in your university, to get involved in a club, a group, to come to the athletics events, to do study abroad if you can, to attend guest lectures, to attend one of our museums. It's amazing everything that we have here, and we did it with you in mind. And yes, we expect you to do your part to ensure that you and those around you are protected against this deadly Delta variant. It's deadly. Make no mistake about it. And that means getting vaccinated, possibly right here today, thanks to Mayor Daniela Levine-Cava and the Florida Department of Health. We have a vaccine station if you care to get one. It only takes one in a family not to be vaccinated. And to wear your face coverings indoors and outdoors if possible. Most importantly, classes, we want you to have pride in our FIU, now your FIU. Wear your FIU swag every day. Be proud of this house that we built together for you. We did all this in 50 years with you in mind. With you in mind. Be proud that you're attending the number one university in the nation's top-ranked state university system right here in Florida. You see, we're number one. FIU. Not those guys, not those up there, us. You're at the number one performing university in the state university system. FIU. That's us. That's you. It's something that you can be proud of. Yeah. So remember, classes of 2024 and 2025, you make it FIU. Congratulations. Let's have a great evening.
Thank you, President Rosenberg. Let's take all of that in. As Senior Vice President of Academic and Student Affairs, our initiatives aim to align curricular and co-curricular activities to improve your educational and professional achievements. We strive for excellence. Chris Lugo is on his way to a timely graduation and that excellence we've all spoken about, and is here to share with you his experiences.
Good afternoon, Panthers! Let me hear you make some noise! That's what I'm talking about. It is with great pleasure I want to welcome you all to this beautiful FIU. You made the right choice. I know most of you are excited, scared, anxious, worried, or all of them to start this new chapter in your life. I know because I was in your position. Coming from a small island, Turks and Caicos, where the number of citizens is roughly 30,000, to FIU, which has doubled in students, was a train wreck of emotions, mainly being scared. I felt like a pet fish going into the ocean. I was always involved in my college back home. I participated in any events I could, excel in my studies. I felt like I could have conquered the world. But when I came to the big city of Miami, I lost hope and thought that my time here at FIU was going to go unnoticed. I was a student who would go to class, get the work done, and go back to my dorm. I didn't want to spend my time at FIU like that. I wanted to make a real impact, but I was scared. Let me share a story with you. I decided to attend Panther in Lake Placid with hundreds of students. There, we had bonding sessions where we had to share something about ourselves. We had the opportunity to learn about what FIU has to offer in a fun way, and we just simply connected. Hearing those stories from other students, staying up late waiting for the sunrise, playing with each other, it empowered me. It made me realize I was not alone. We were students from different backgrounds and culture. And I assure you that almost everyone cried with emotions, sharing their stories and being able to relate to one another. What's fun is that during the bus ride to Lake Placid, I told myself I was going to meet as many campers as I could, learn as much as I can. But something I did not know was that my life was going to turn flip upside down. I went on to join SGA as the engineering senator, joined the e-board of the largest tech organization at FIU called UPE, got a 4.0 GPA, and became widely known in the FIU community all in my first semester. And because of that, Dr. Behar noticed that, and now I have this amazing opportunity to be speaking to you all. I learned that in FIU, there's a place for me. Same way I tell you, there's a place for you. You all have the power to forge your future. It all starts by building connections. Panther Camp may not be your spark, but look at the persons around you. Meet someone you don't know. That's how it all starts. Help each other. Who knows? You could be the future SGA president, be involved in SPC, BSU, homecoming, or even be right here sharing your story to the next set of Panthers. It is okay to be afraid, but always remember, there is a place here for you in FIU. Here's your assignment. Meet at least 3 people in here. Share contacts, share your passions. If I can do it, and if they can do it, so you can definitely do it. Ask yourself, what type of student, what type of Panther do you want to be? What legacy do you want to leave behind? Turn to your neighbor real quick and tell them, I'm going to make a real impact. Come on. Turn to your neighbor and tell them, I'm going to make a real impact. Now, it's up to you to believe that. Feel free to stop me if you see me or any of those students in the back. We are here for you. FIU is here for you. Thank you.
How about that, Chris Lugo? He's got it going, and you can have it going too. Thank you, Chris. To date, ladies and gentlemen, there have been 49 graduating classes. I know we have a number of graduates sitting out there right now as parents or grandparents. This evening, your banners classes are being presented by your classmates. First, for the freshmen, we have Grace McCullough. Grace is a graduate of Teaneck High School in Teaneck, New Jersey. She was on the varsity track and cross-country team for 4 years and holds 3 school records. She is passionate about sustainability and environmental activism and is majoring in hospitality management with a focus on tourism and event planning. Grace was recognized as a College Board National Scholar and is a member of our Honors College. Second, we have Carlos Gonzalez. Carlos is a graduate of iMatter Prep High School in Miami and earned his Associate Arts degree at the same time as his high school diploma. He has a passion for math and medicine and aspires to innovate the medical field by integrating transformative engineering techniques. He majors in biomedical engineering. He's a presidential scholar and a member of the Honors College as well. And now, And now for the sophomores, first we have Imani Wooden. Imani is a graduate of Lincoln High School in Tallahassee, where she spent her senior year as an exchange student in Brazil. She's currently working on campus with the Center for Student Engagement. As an engagement liaison, she helps connect students with opportunities to get involved at our FIU. Imani is majoring in international relations with a minor in Portuguese and is a member of the Honors College. And last, we have Lewis Morris. Lewis is a graduate of Hialeah Gardens High School. He just completed an internship with the Florida House of Representatives, and this fall, he'll be in Washington as a policy intern with the Cato Institute, which is one of the country's top think tanks. A peer advisor and student ambassador, Lewis is pursuing two bachelor's degrees in political science and criminal justice with a certificate in pre-law, and he's a member of the Honors College. Class of 2024 and 2025, we now present your class banners. Good job. Good job. Thank you. Before we conclude, ladies and gentlemen, we do want to make sure that you know that you all are invited, family members, students, to our official welcome party. Head over with your squad, get your tickets for free food, grab some giveaways, and learn about getting involved. Will the class of 2024 and 2025 please stand? Class, we have many traditions at our Panther convocation. This is one of the first traditions that you will experience. We will now present the torch of knowledge. As the torch passes your row, we know that you will rise and recognize that this is an ancient symbol of learning, and it's been with FIU since its first days. The passing of the torch, classes, means that you are now a part of the FIU's academic community. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now have the passing of the torch of knowledge. Please stand or remain standing as the torch passes your row. The torch is being carried by FIU alumna and Senior Vice President of Academic and Student Affairs, Dr. Elizabeth Behar. Dr. Behar passes the torch to the FIU Alumni Association President, Gina Duarte Romero. Gina is a two-time alumnus who earned a bachelor's degree in 1991 and a master's in education in 2008. Ms. Duarte Romero passes the torch to Alexander Rubido. He's the president of Student Government Association and a member of the FIU Board of Trustees. Mr. Rubido now passes the torch to a freshman representative of the class of 2025. Mr. Rubio passes the torch to Nicolas Quintana. Nicolas is a graduate of Miami Arts Studio at Zelda Glazer. His senior year, he organized a theatrical project that focused on the challenges veterans face coming home after war and transitioning back to civil life. Both Nicolas's parents are graduates of FIU's Department of Theater, and he is following in their footsteps with the same major. Nicholas is a recipient of the Silver Knight Award in theater and is looking forward to performing on stage at our Herbert and Nicole Wertheim Performing Arts Center. Now that you are part of our academic community, your desire for knowledge classes and to build strong character will burn as brightly as the torch of knowledge. Our need for you to be aggressive lifelong learners and for you to build strong character is as intense as the light generated by this torch. We know that you will exceed expectations, and we know that you will take your engagement in this world to a new level. We know that you will have an impact. You will make a difference. You will be worlds ahead. Congratulations. Please be seated.
Thank you again, students, valued guests, and family members for celebrating with us today. Now, the combined efforts of many individuals go into making an event like this possible, so will you please join me in recognizing the efforts of the Panther Convocation Committee and the many student leaders for their dedication and hard work in putting together this ceremony for all of us. Now we ask if you will please remain in your place until the end of the recessional of the platform party and the faculty. And now, will the student leaders please take their places for the recessional? Will the Grand Marshal, the SGA President, and Rory please prepare for the recessional? Will the platform party please rise? I now call President Rosenberg to the podium.
Will the class of 2024 and 2025 please stand? We hope to see you here, as we've said, immediately after this Panther convocation concludes. We want to meet your families. We want to say hello to you. And we hope that you're part of our official party as it gets going. Well, we said this evening would be lit. We want to congratulate you on your new beginning. We're excited about your journey at our FIU. You see, this is the beginning. Class of 2024 and 2025, let's go!